We start with big news out of Atlanta. The Braves agree to terms with free agent starting pitcher Dallas Keuchel on a one-year deal that will pay the 2015 AL Cy Young winner $13 million over the remainder of the season. Now, the move comes just a day after the Cubs agreed to sign Craig Kimbrel. Now, AJ, we've been talking about Dallas going to the Braves. How does he improve their chances now in the National League?
Well, it gives them depth in the rotation. They have a lot of question marks. Yes, they have some good guys. Soroka's been great. Is he on a pitch count, an innings limit? They said yes. We don't know what it is. Max Fried, is he on a pitch limit? He's been great for them. Tehran's been good. Fulton Nevich has struggled. He missed spring training. They need him to kind of get it going to where he is. But he'll give them another option. Gausman struggled for him. He'll give him innings. He'll save some of those innings from the young kid. And he'll save the bullpen. The bullpen's been the question mark kind of for the Braves from the get-go. But if you put a veteran starter in there that you know every fifth day is going to take the ball, can give you six, seven innings, it saves those bullpen arms for another day. So does he help? Yes. Is he the final piece for the Braves to say, hey, they're going to win the World Series? Probably not, but he is a nice addition. And if I'm Scott Boras and I'm Dallas Keuchel, I'm like, $13 million? I know it's a lot of money, but that's it? He couldn't get a multi-year deal?
$17.9 million that he turned down on a one-year deal. So he'll certainly lose money, obviously, and he had to wait for this amount of time. And two, Amber, you think about, you go back on the market one offseason from now, how much different could the circumstances be? Now, certainly he won't have the draft pick attached to him this time around in the winter of 19-20, which certainly should help him out in that regard. But this is not the way that he envisioned things going. If he thought he was going to be able to get this amount of money, he would have just accepted the QO from the Astros to begin with. But, AJ, to your point, I think just as importantly as the Braves getting him, the Phillies don't. Mm-hmm. And the Phillies could have used him in a big way. We talked yesterday about how much they're a right-handed dominant rotation there in Philadelphia. He would have given them a nice contrast there. And, AJ, to your point, both Gausman and Fulton Nevich, ERAs above six over the last month. This is an arm the Braves needed. This is a huge development, I believe, in the National League East.
So now do the Phillies go Bumgarner? Do they go, like we said last night, the Cubs got Kimbrel. Do the Brewers now react and go get somebody? We thought it might be Keuchel. Instead, he went to the Braves. Do the Phillies do the same thing and say, hey, we got to go get a Bumgarner. We got to go get a Trevor Bauer. We got to go get a Kluber if he's healthy.
Right.
Whatever starting pitcher they think they need, does this intensify their...
Yes. It should. And they need that type of a pitcher, I believe. They also, of course, need potentially some offensive help with McCutchen being out. But the Phillies, we talked about them a long time ago, AJ. They're going to be one of the more active teams of any in baseball at the deadline. And this was a tough week for them. They lose McCutchen. They don't sign Kimbrel. They don't sign Keuchel. This is a tough week, a tough few days for them off the field. And I think it's going to make them even more aggressive in the weeks to come.
Really quick, I want to go back to what you said about the bullpen needing maybe one more arm to shore him up for the Braves. JP, they do have a lot of prospect capital. Can you see them going out and doing that?
Yes, I can. I think Shane Green is one name to watch a lot in Detroit. He's had a lot of save opportunities, been very active there in the bullpen here for a team that's out of it. I think Green is a guy that's certainly going to move, I believe, in the weeks to come.
Okay, so the Braves getting stronger there in the National League East. Carlos Carrasco went on the IL yesterday. He joins Corey Kluber, amongst others. They're 10.5 games now behind the Twins in the Central. Is there any reason to believe that they won't be sellers at the deadline?
Amber, I think they could at least hold. I don't see them buying at this point in time because they're that far back in the divisional race. They're not going to buy in an effort to try to just get that wild card spot, given where they've been as a team the last several years. I think that at this point in time, selling probably is about at a 50% probability. Holding is about 40%. I mean, there's a very, very small chance that they buy at the end. But I think for this team right now, not going to trade Lindor. He's too valuable to them in the offseason to potentially move then. But the likes of Trevor Bauer, Brad Hand, Carlos Santana, if they fall out far enough, Amber and AJ, I think that we could maybe see the Indians shift into that mode right now just because they know how good they were in the past and they're a pretty far distance from that club.
But they're not going to sell, obviously, until after the All-Star game.
Correct.
They should sell. But the problem is a lot of those guys aren't free agents. Bauer,
Brad
Kluber, Brad Hand, Santana.
Right.
They all have another year left. So if you sell now, it kind of gives the fans for next year no hope.
Well, correct. Now, granted, look at where their attendance is right now. They're not exactly going in huge numbers at this point in time. So if they're going to position themselves and say, listen, we need to have a repositioning as our organization right now and look to the future, you might as well make the tough decision right now. I understand that the fans may react a certain way, AJ, but you look at the Twins right now. How much better are the Twins right now than the Indians? Pretty substantial.
About 10.5 games.
Exactly.
I mean, they're about 10.5 games better.
Correct. And trending even, that distance is probably going to get wider next year, too. So the question is this. If you don't think you can be better than them next year with this current current cast, you have to make some tough decisions, which they've done in the past. They've traded Cliff Lee in the past. They've traded CC Sabathia in the past, Mark DeRosa in the past, when those guys were the guys to get at the deadline. Same front office, basically. I think they'll make the same decision this time.
You just
around.
Put Cliff Lee, CC Sabathia, and Mark DeRosa in the same statement, by the way. I'm just saying.
Yes. 2009, D-Row was the guy, and it was moved at that point in time. But I think they've made some tough decisions.
But if they don't sell, like you said, they might just hold. Okay, and say they are only two games out of the wild card. It's fool's gold. That's the problem with a lot of the second wild card. Yeah, you might get into the wild card, and yeah, you might bring in someone, you might sell some prospects, but you get one game, and then you get bounced out of the playoff.
You want a series. You don't want one game.
If you're going in, you got to go in to get the series and win the division. You can't go in for the one game because you lose the one game. All that hard work and everything is gone. It's great. Oh, we made the playoffs. Great.
Right.
But at the end of the day, I want a series.
And to your point, they saw when they were on the same field as the Astros last year in the playoffs, they weren't nearly good enough to compete with that team. And not enough has changed in the positive direction.
They were a better team last year.
I agree. Exactly. And I think that they realize how good they were in the past. And then this is the last point I'll make on this is, for some teams, making it to the wild card is worth it. For the Indians, it's not. Because they've been there many, many times. They know that they have to move on.
Just to reiterate what you said, Lindor stays for now. We will not see him traded until possibly the winter where they get more value for him, correct?
More teams will be involved then.
Okay.